Hey, we're out here picking peas. You know what? These are Mr. Big Pea. Look how big they are. I already started picking. I thought I'll make a video because these peas just keep going on and on and on. Here's a big Mr. Big Pea. Now, I picked a bunch already. I can't see because it's reflecting in there. But I picked all of these. All of these. Put them in my little basket. I'm dropping them. Oops, didn't drop it. That's actually on the plant, but they're really not big enough to pick. You can kind of feel, I guess. I guess I could take off my gloves. But lots of big peas. And Mikey don't like peas, but Seesmic loves them if I open them up for him. But you know what? You think you want to pee? You want to pee? Seesmic wants to pee. Here, let me open them up. He loves his peas. Oh, sorry. Here, have some peas. Here. Seesmic, have some peas. So give me them peas. Give me them peas. He loves them. He says, I like my peas. I'm a pea eater. So I sat here and gave him a whole bunch. You know what I do with the extra peas? Instead of putting them in the compost, I throw them back there, and then I'll till them under here pretty soon. But more peas. This is just on my little side plot. Don't get into the peas. And oh, let me pick that one up. He won't open them up. He's a lazy dog. Here. Here, have the whole plant. He says, I don't do plants. Maybe. He might take it. Weeds. Anyway, so I got these peas left. I pulled out my cascade peas. But Mr. Big Pea, they just keep on coming. And you never pull them when they're wet. I made the mistake. And it says in all the instructions everywhere not to pull them if they're wet. So I pull them before I water them. Nice one. I'm seeing such a reflection on the iPhone. Mikey's just taking it. He's nice today, but supposed to get around 80. And these are an update on the tomato plants. This little pathetic kind of holder thing is kind of sad. Oh, well, I'll replace it. I kind of ran out of tomato cages, and I better think about doing something quick. So these are looking good. And over on this side, I think that's thyme there. Yes, thyme. Weeds down there. Uh-oh. I forgot the name of that. That is not good. This one's persimmon, Japanese ox heart, and I just know this is orange ox heart. And those are weeds. But they're coming along pretty good. Now this little area doesn't get a whole bunch of stuff. Let's go up here. Check this out. A whole bunch of sun is what I meant to say. And this, these tomatoes are doing good. Jelly, great. I forgot what that is back there. But this is a jelly. And this is Ordorico. These two, they're looking good. These two are carbon. They were so good they won the tomato contest up in Fullerton. This is where that yellow pear volunteer was. I took out. That was all diseased. This is grape. And these two are sweet gold. Look how big the sweet gold is getting. When it get a little bigger, I'm going to just take something and go from here to here and just kind of try to hold them up a little more simply this time. Sun gold, I've got two of those. Let's see. Do I have two? Yes. Well, I have two sweet gold and two. I thought I had two sun gold. And there's the Bonnie original, which was, I put in way before the sun gold. I can hardly wait to get to taste a sun gold and sweet gold. They were so good last year. And my green zebras over here doesn't get as much sun, doesn't get full sun. Probably the Bonnie original and the sun golds get the most sun. And as you can see, as you work down there, they're all doing a little good, better. They're all doing okay, but these right here, they don't get as much sun as these do right here. but they have flowers. So please give me some tomatoes. Don't just fall off. I want a tomato. Oh well. Come on, Sun Gold. Do your thing.